Hello everyone, I welcome you all to my channel. Today I am going to show you how you can easily use Visual Studio Code for Java programming. So I am going to show you in detail how you can start your Java programming in Visual Studio Code. So I am going to talk about all the plugins, extensions and all that. So you know, do watch the video till the end. If you face any issues in middle, you can always put a comment in our comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. Now to use Java in Visual Studio Code, you need to open a browser and you need to just simply search over here Java in Visual Studio, right, and hit enter. And when you do that, you're going to show you this Java in Visual Studio Code. So just simply open that and it's going to open this page. So this link I'm going to put right in our description. So here you can see that we have a beautiful tutorial available on Visual Studio Code official site. So from here I need to click on this install the coding pack for Java for Windows. If you are into macOS, then you can select this one. For Windows, this is enough. And if you scroll down, you can see that detailed documentation right about how to use Java in Visual Studio Code. So don't worry, I'm going to talk more about this in this video, so you can just simply follow this video itself. So here you can see that our Java coding pack is now downloaded. So let's click on that to install it locally on our system. And you can see that our coding pack for Java is rightly opened over here. Let's first minimize our browser. And this is our license agreement. Let's accept this, click on next. And here it is telling that we need to install Java development kit first, that is JDK, and then Visual Studio Code itself, right? So these are all the action items. So it's going to do it for us. Just simply hit install and it's going to start fetching our JDK from internet and going to install it locally on our system. So it has rightly started. So let's wait for some time. So it is preparing to install our Java. And now if you see that our Java is installed, so here you can see that it is installing JDK, installing adopt or open JDK, and then install JDK completed. But after that you can see that when it started in but after that you can see that when it tried to download Visual Studio Code, it is facing some issue. It is retrying, but again error occurred. So ultimately it failed, right? So it failed to download our Visual Studio Code and installing it locally on our system. Don't worry. So you can see that we have this button like install manually, right? So you need to click on that. So when you click on that, it's going to navigate to the official site of Visual Studio Code. And from here, you need to click on this download button. So when you click on that, it's going to download our Visual Studio setup. And you can see that our Visual Studio is rightly downloaded over here. So let's click on this open file. And let's minimize our browser. So let's first close this coding pack for Java. So we only have Visual Studio set up now. So accept the license agreement, click on next. So this is where our Visual Studio Code is going to be installed. Click on next. And it's going to create Visual Studio Code. Just find the folder, click on next, and here you need to select all these options, all right, and click on next. So it's ready to be installed. Click on install and there you go, you can see it is preparing to install. So let it get finished installing our Visual Studio Code. So you can see that our Visual Studio Code is rightly installed. Click on finish to launch our Visual Studio Code, and our Visual Studio Code is rightly opened over here. So so you can choose any theme, like this is dark modern, then dark high contrast and all that. So I'll just simply choose dark modern, and I'll also close this welcome note. So what I'm going to quickly show you is to talk about the extensions, right? You need to click on these extensions, and here you need to just simply type Java. So when you type Java, it's going to show you this extension pack for Java, right? And it is developed by Microsoft itself. So if you click on that, it's going to show you the same thing on our browser, right? So let's minimize browser. So what you need to do is you need to click on the install button over here. So it's going to start installing it. You can see that it's going to also install all these, you know, different extensions. So you can see it is showing install, right? So Maven for Java, Project Manager for Java, Test Runner for Java, Debugger for Java. So all these, you know, extensions it's going to install along with the extension pack. So that's why it is telling extension pack, right? And you can see it is installed now. So let's close this now then and go back to our Explorer, open folder, and let's create a folder in our document directory. I'll name this folder as java_practice, and I'm going to select this folder, and you'll be able to see that our folder is rightly opened over here. Yes, I trust the authors, right? So our folder is rightly open. Let's create a new file. So click on this and just simply give a new file name, that like hello.java, and hit enter, and you'll be able to see that it is rightly opened. So here you can just simply type class, and immediately you can see one template over here coming, right? So all you need to do is you need to just simply hit enter. Once you hit enter, you can see automatically that template came, like public class hello. Now the next thing that we need to do is you need to create a public static void main. So again, as soon as you type, you can see the template coming. So you need to, you know, go to click on that, press that down key, and again hit enter. Immediately you can see, you know, it is rightly created our main method. So now we'll just simply type system.out.println. Again, we'll use IntelliSense, and we'll just simply print over here hello world, right? And as I have told, once you have all plugin installed, you'll be able to see this run button. So you need to click on this run button, and it's going to start compiling our Java. So if this pop-up comes, you need to just simply click on allow. This is just a Windows security thing, you need to give allow, right? And here you can see the output coming hello world. So in this way, you can easily use our Visual Studio Code for Java programming. In my next video, I'm going to talk about how you can easily use our same Visual Studio Code itself for Python programming. So, you know, stay tuned, do subscribe our channel, and press that bell button to get notification. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.